Hey everybody, my name is Brendan Mitchell over here at Carolina Motion Controls, and today I'm here with an ACS380 as well as an IEC motor from ABB. Today I'm going to show you how to input motor data into a drive using a motor nameplate. The motor nameplate is where you will find all the values needed to input into the drive. Once your motor is connected to your drive, you're ready to turn your drive on. Once your drive is on, you'll be on the home view. From your home view, select OK to go to the main menu. From the main menu, navigate to the motor parameter menu and select OK. Here we will change our motor parameters. Our first motor parameter is motor type. Your options are asynchronous motor, permanent magnet synchronous motor, synchronous reluctance motor, and permanent magnet synchronous reluctance motor. Our demo uses an asynchronous motor. Your next parameter is control mode. Your two options are scalar and vector. Vector uses two parameters, frequency and phase angle, to control voltage and current, while scalar only uses frequency. We will be using vector. Once you select vector, a warning appears, AFF6. AFF6 means that the motor will perform an ID run when it is started. We are ready to continue. The next parameter is nominal power. Because the nameplate said 0.11 kilowatts, we will convert it to 0.15 horsepower. We get another warning, A6, A4. This means that we have entered incorrect parameters, but it will go away after entering the rest of the parameters. The next parameter is current. We will input 0.7 amps. After we input the nominal current, the A6, A4 warning goes away due to the current and voltage matching the nominal power. We will move on to the next parameter. Nominal voltage. For nominal voltage, we will input 260 volts. Next is nominal frequency. For this, we will input 60 hertz. Next parameter is nominal speed. Here, we will input 1640 revolutions per minute. Next is torque. We will leave that at 0 pounds per foot. Next parameter is phase order. We will leave our phase order at UVW. To reverse direction easily, choose UWV. For phase angle or cos phi, we will input 0.55. And last but not least, we will choose United States units. Now that we have input all the motor data, we need to perform a standstill ID run on the motor. Press start to begin your ID run. During this process, the motor is injected with DC current in order to identify motor characteristics. After your standstill ID run is finished, you can now run your motor. Here, I will run my motor at 1000 RPMs. That's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to contact us using our information in the description below. Thanks for watching.